in his epic series against Jimmy McClung, Barney Ross held the welterweight title for 3 years. Then in May 1938, he accepted a challenge from featherweight champion Henry Armstrong. Armstrong concedes almost 10 kilograms to Ross, but he's a relentless fighter who can absorb severe punishment. He takes the early points.
Championship fight, of course, it's due to go 15 rounds. Well, if it carries on like this, it's hard to see how Barney Ross can win this fight. He really is fighting the wrong sort of contest. He's got to try and back Armstrong up and work behind his jab, but Armstrong is just keeping wading forward. And if it's a barroom brawl, there really is only one winner. Head's going in, the shoulders are going in, and Barney Ross is being worked over. Touch of gloves as they ended the fourth, now we're going to the fifth. Barney Ross's trainer Art Winch has surely told him he's got to get up on his toes and got to get back and work behind his jab, and he's moving backwards trying to do that, but a good shot for Armstrong. One-sided fight. Armstrong, the smaller man, the lighter man, but unquestionably the stronger man, and won that round by a street. Goes the distance, there can only be one winner now. Barney Ross really does have to knock Henry Armstrong out, and it's hard to see where any sort of punch of that intensity is going to come from. A jab of Ross, no more than a pouring sort of move, just a minor irritant to Armstrong as he wades in. When he does get in close, Ross really not doing a great deal more than surviving. Those body shots are real energy sapping blows, and Armstrong again completely in control. 15th and final round. Great respect between these two men, but Barney Ross now knows he's facing an inevitable defeat. Staggering, tottering around the ring, somehow finding the strength to fire back, but no power in those punches. Round just as surely as he has probably 13 or 14